We came to you a few years ago and there was an overwhelming response. So today we have come with a fresh set of experts. We've got Vivek Sharma, he's the director of Future Constructions. We've got Akash Fadnis, he's the advocate on the show. And he's from ELSERV Advocates and Legal Consultants. And I have Pankaj Navlakha. He's the Director of Urban Landmarks. Thank you so much for joining us. Akash will be joining us shortly. Let's get the ball rolling. Let me first talk to Vivek. Vivek, what kind of demand do you see for plots in Pune today?
Basically, we deal in a Hinjewadi, only Hinjewadi area. That area, people come around from north, basically. From UP, Bihar, MP and Rajasthan. The first state, most of the people come from first state. They all are looking some of the plot where they can reside after some time. Currently, they are buying in a future investment, but after some time, 5 years, in 10 years down the line, they can stay over there. The Hinjewadi is almost growing area. That place, anybody going to invest something, people definitely growing their money after some time. So people are looking a small piece of land over there, not the huge demand of 11,000 square feet to 30,000 square feet. They are looking 2,000, 3,000 as small piece of land.
Right. And what sizes are, you said 2,000 square feet. Is this in gated communities? What are the facilities that...
My old project with the gated community, with all the modern amenities. None of the project I have which only have a land. I give all those amenities like clubhouse, garden, pools, CCTV camera, roads, dustbin, drainage, security levels, everything.
And actually, when you give all these amenities, does that enhance the value of the land, the property that you sell?
Definitely. You can understand people have bought their land 5-6 years ago. Land can't increase their values. The area, once the area grow, value grow. So once you are making the gated amenities, definitely the area is growing. And once the area is growing, your amount will be appreciated like anything.
Oh. Normally, how much does land appreciate? In what time?
Question.
How long should somebody hold on to a land investment for appreciation?
So minimum 3 years, they must be they have hold. For 5 to 10 years, if a horizon, you have a 5 to 10 year horizon, I can assure you, you can get 3 to 4 times return minimum.
Now I'm going to come to Vivek. Vivek, which parts of Pune do you deal in?
Me.
Oh, sorry. Pankaj, which parts of Pune do you deal in?
Madam, basically I deal in the southeast part of Pune, where the development at present is not as much in hype, but the future forecast, the airport and the ring road, which are being developed in Pune, they are being situated in this part of Pune. Right. So the people get good appreciation for the investments over there.
Right. And this is a newly developing area, right?
Right.
What is its profile? What are its drivers? Who buys it?
Yeah, basically, at present, if we are considering 10 people, 3 to 4 people are local residents. Rest all are investors who are buying the land for future forecast. They have a horizon of 3 to 5 years of investment and they are expecting the rates to be going up. So the people come over there and have their investments with us. And we have given good results and returns here before also.
So, and what sizes are popular here?
Basically, we have a size from 1200 square feet to 5000 square feet. We give a variety of ticket size. Mm-hmm. Depending on the customer's requirement, he can adjust accordingly.
And what is the most popular ticket size?
Most popular 2000 to 2500 square feet.
Okay. And normally in price terms, what would be the ticket size? How much would people spend on that?
Our product is from 8 lakhs to 25 lakhs. So maximum people are in the range of 10 to 12 lakhs. They are interested in that ticket size.
Okay. And Vivek, what price ranges are most popular with you?
10 lakhs is the most popular price in around our area.
Now, what is the profile of, let's talk about the profile of the buyers. Who's buying, you said that three three out of 10 people buy for self-use. Who are these people who plan to stay there, and in what time frame will they come and stay?
What I understand about that, the Hinjewadi area, among the most the IT company, people have from north only. The middle class job seekers is from north only. Four states, UP, Bihar, MP and Rajasthan. So they are doing job over here. They think that Pune environment is really very good among all those states. So they are good. So if they are working here, they can stay also. They think if I'm going to sell after some time, I'll get money. If I want to stay here, I can stay too. So they have their mind ki if we are living in doing job in the Pune, we can stay in future also. So okay. They are looking land like that ki if we are giving some gated communities land. One of my project have the future city. All those IT company have their employee in that project. So 25 acre project. So all those IT peoples in that project. Currently some of them are making home over there.
Pankaj, who's the end user buyer for you?
Madam, the end user are people who are associated to the village. Actually, they have a job over the cities, but they don't have the basic land over in their own village. So they prefer to make a provision for the future after their retirement and all. They can shift over there. And the local people who are not having that big house or that big apartment over there, they also prefer to make future provision and they buy the land for their self-use.
So when they buy the land, do they have to get the plan sanctioned themselves or you have some standard plans?
No. Actually, I deal in all the sanctioned projects only. My total projects are PMRDA-TP sanctioned. And we have all the plan sanctions done, the NA permissions done. We also have all the infrastructure and we give a gated community where the person doesn't need to run here and there for the permissions and for the sanctions. We provide the future plan sanctions also for his construction if he's interested with us, or he can do it by himself.
Oh. And normally after buying, how long is it before the end users start getting their plan sanctioned and building begun?
Actually, it depends on person to person. Actually, we see some people actually who are interested to start their construction immediately. So in my projects, I have people who have constructed while I am developing the project. So that gives me a plus point also for the sale of the project. Yeah. So the project is moving fast in that way.
Right. How many floors you can construct? Does that depend on how wide the road is leading up to the plot?
Yes, surely it depends on that. And basically, based on that, the FSI is allotted, how much open space and how much road width we have left. The proportion of construction of the plot depends on this. Now, that is called a pro rata FSI. So, with in our sanctioned projects, the customer gets near about 1.3 to 1.5 times of the plot which he has bought. So, depending on that, 3 plus floor are required to consume the total FSI.
Right. How important is it to have wider roads leading up to your plot development?
Now, when we are seeing Pune city, the present scenario, all areas, anywhere if we have to go, all are choked up with traffic. And that is transferring to the internal side of the societies also. So, it is a very important factor. And wherein sanctioned government has made strict norm that 9 meter minimum road is required. And accordingly, that I think so is the basic necessity for a safe and peaceful community to reside in the societies.
Vivek, what size of roads do you build on?
Is it 30 feet and above?
Sorry?
30 feet and above.
30 feet and above. That makes it premium?
Premium.
Right. Normally, depending on the width of the road, how much of a premium gets loaded onto the cost of the plot?
It depends on the project. Every project has different type of cost. So if the project cost is very high, the cost going to high. The project cost is low, the loading is going to low. It's depend on the project cost.
Oh.
And it's vary always project to project. It can't be constant. We can say this much of the area percentage. It's always depend on the project.
I have some queries coming in from our users who are logged on. There's an Amit Singh of Pune who says, what are the government authorities who give approvals for plot projects in Pune? What should a buyer check before buying a plot in Pune? Pankaj, would you like to take this?
Yes, ma'am. Actually, for before anything, we have to make the land NA. When we are actually dealing in the lands that are agricultural lands, actually for projects of plotting, so they must be first converted into non-agriculture lands. After that, we can go for the sanctioning of the plotting layout which we are planning on that land. That is sanctioned by either town planning if it's outside the PMRDA limits, or if it's within the limits of Pune Metropolitan Regional Development Authority, which has a new body passed recently. So we have to get the sanction from that. And then the lastly comes after the sanction of the plots are done, the RERA. We get approval for RERA also, so that the customer gets loans easily for his future investment requirements at a best rates. If RERA is sanctioned, banks are easily giving the finance, and at best rates, it's near about the housing rates.
How much loan can you get, Vivek? How much loan can a consumer get to buy a plot?
70 to 80% approx.
And this is a composite loan or this is an individual plot loan?
It's individual plot loan.
And do they also give composite loans?
Yes, definitely.
For land plus building?
Buildings. It's, it depends. If you are buying for that, you have to sanction. First, you have to sanction plan for your home. Then only you can get that type of the loan.
And what do people normally go for? Plot loans?
Currently in our area, people don't get loan basically. Max of the people buying from the saving.
Right.
Only few people, 4 to 5% people are taking loan.
Oh, really? Okay. And do they pay in installments or it's a one-time payment?
Sometimes we have the scheme where we can give installment up to 5 years, up to 7 years. And we do all those documentation and position immediate. So people don't get loan over there.
And it is registered?
It's a registered.
So which means that as soon as I buy with you, I register the...
Within a 45 days, land will be in your name.
Okay. And then the payment can be made over a period of up to 5 years.
5 years, yes.
Okay.
Even we give position to.
You get position. Pankaj, do you have any similar scheme running?
Actually, we are not under the installment scheme. We prefer the customer taking their own bank loans and paying us upfront. Immediately, we do the sale deed in their name. We have the society register for the plotting and we take their names in the society records also immediately.
And now let me ask you a more global question about Pune. Which are those areas in Pune where you think there is good prospects for plot development? Okay.
Madam, actually Pune is an upcoming city and the ring road is being developed around Pune. So any part of Pune is going to be fruitful for you. But now the rates are reasonable in the southeast part of Pune. Other areas already has been developed and the rates are spiked already. So I would prefer people coming in the southeast so they can get a good return on their investment for the future.
So tell me any four places that you would personally say that these are good plot investments and why?
Actually, looking that way, the southeast part, because the airport is coming over there, the Pirangud.
So what are the localities then?
Saswat is the main locality over there, and other similar cities, Vanpuri is there, Udachiwadi, and then small cities are nearby. The next Pirangud area, nearby Hinjwadi, that is also a good investment destination, and the ring road is passing through the Gotabaya. So they can get their investments nicely placed over there. The third area would be the Somatne Fata and all, which is not as presently that spike. So that way also the investments can be increased. And the last area I would be Bombay Pune Road, but the rates are already too heavy over there. Bombay Pune Road is also a good destination for him. So.
What about you? Would you like to give us some three, four areas which where land is good to buy?
In the PCMC, all those area, what they said, I'm okay with all those. But then some area which can be seen like anything. You have heard about the Tathawade.
Mm-hmm.
Near about the Tathawade, the huge area going to develop very soon. Because they have three side roads. One side ring road and two side 120 feet internal roads. That area called, Pushane.
Mm-hmm.
Pachane Pushane. That huge area, almost 2,000 acre land over there, that area is going to improve like anything. The rate is currently is very below over that area. But mm-hmm. once it will be road will be demarcated, the rate will be grow like anything.
Both of you have talked about infrastructure developments and how they impact the plot buying in Pune. Normally, when a government announces an infrastructure, does the price of land spike? And sometimes the infrastructure doesn't come. Then what happens?
Actually, in plotting, the main purpose of people buying the land is that some future development is coming over there. So the basic 50 to 60% of the land cost is because of that appreciation which they are expecting to be happening. Mm-hmm. If by the way, some reasons it doesn't happen, it will impact, but that will not make a major impact because already people have invested over there, and then once the rates are done, there is no reversal as big as that which can happen.
Like you had Talegaon, Chakan and so on, where they were supposed to be new drivers, but those drivers have shifted, right?
Right. The was initially planned over there, but after that, industry was developed. So some compensation was made by that developing industry. Airport is shifted, but still we can get the rates as same as the which were initially.
Okay. So the rate of growth of the plot does not change.
Right, it not affected at that much, 10-20% maximum.
Okay. Vivek, what about you?
So according to me, we are drilling at Hinjewadi area. That area is developed already.
Yeah.
The development is ongoing, not something is going to happen. Mm-hmm. And what's this area going to develop is not depend on government. Because the top five township in Hinjewadi area only, the Exarvia, the Life Republic from Kolte Patel, Banyan Tree. So Nyati is coming with 250 acres project. So all those the top project in that area only. So not mm-hmm. it's not depend on the government only. Once government will do something, it will be grow. The private player is investing like anything. They want to secure their money. So they are developing on their own cost also. So that area going to sure develop. People should not worry about that.
Oh, I understand. We're going to take some more queries that have come in. There is Amit Singh who says, which are the government authorities who give approvals for plot projects? What should a buyer check? I think you spoke about that.
PMRD only.
Yeah.
One part in that actually, madam. The title also plays an important role. And presently, whichever project we are launching, we are having a search from 1930. Basically, when the 712 extract was established in India or in the land system. So we take all the search title precautions before launching any project. So that is also an important part of that.
Is there some... Go on. Finish what you're saying.
Yes, we have discussed, I think. So the sanctioning authorities and the other
part. Is there any online... Is there any way of checking your property titles online?
Yes, now everything is available on online. People can go on the government e-websites and they can surely check all the details.
Okay. So, before I buy, you recommend that people should check online?
We actually recommend, we give our search title report also, and we prefer them appointing a lawyer, legal expert, who can take the things forward for them. Okay. So they don't have any doubt.
There is another query that has come from Mukesh Rao. What is the best location? I think we have discussed that. Jia Singh, do we need to get any plot to construct an R-zone plot in Pune? Do you need to get an any plot to construct in an R-zone plot in Pune?
Yes, sir.
One of you, who would like to take that query?
R-zone plots are there, madam, but for the sanctioning, when we go for the sanctioning, they'll ask for the NA permissions also.
Okay.
So that doesn't matter if it is a R-zone plot, we have to go for the NA permission, and basically that is required by based on all other factors which the government norms should be satisfied. So that then only we can go for the construction. Only being an R-zone land doesn't make it constructible.
Right. You do need your NA permissions, right?
Yeah. Yes.
Vivek, Brijesh Sharma asks, is it safe to buy a Guntha plot on an NA, non-NA land in Pune?
It's a depend. If area is more than 11,000, this is safe.
Oh. If it's less than 11,000, you should not.
Because that will not transfer your name.
There is Neha who says, I'm looking to buy a plot in Pune. I have a budget of 5 to 10 lakh. Where can I buy? Which areas have good prospects? 5 to 10 lakh, is that a good budget to buy in Pune, a piece of land?
Yes.
Yeah, ma'am.
Okay. Where would you recommend? Now, actually, I think what we need to tell our users is how to determine, if they're planning to come as investors, how to determine what are the factors that grow the price of land. It could be job hubs, it could be infrastructure and so on, right?
So if they have the budget 5 to 10 lakhs, they cannot buy any land near about Pune. They must be go some far. And if they have the think about they are looking to farmhouse plot, something for the future, they can buy easily. So if they have the budget like 5 lakh rupees in around Pune, there is not possibility to buy. None of the project, none of the company have the budget 5 lakhs in a plot in the Pune. So if they going some far, it's depend on where she is working, where they're living, it's all depends. So far differentiation is different for everyone. For me, Hadapsari is far, and somebody is Hadapsari living, Hinjawadi is far. So far definition always change, depend on the person.
Yeah, but then Hadapsar has the proximity to some job hubs. Hinjawadi is a job hub by itself, right? So why don't we tell people, what should you consider when you're buying a property?
See, what I believe in is someone is not going to stay right now. They must be think about the future. The area is in future going to change something. And how I can assure? I'm telling you some of the example where people can assure about that. Think about the developer who going to invest their 100 CR, 50 CR, 60 CR somewhere. They must research about that, the area. Then only they invest. They not just take their money and buy something. Right. They research. We have the research team. We work minimum 2 years. Then we can buy a big project only. Right. So if the developer have researched somewhere, the big project, 20 acre, 50 acre, 200 acre, like that area is not depend on government only. Once government will develop something, we'll get some developed things. Why I prefer, we have got so many proposal from other area of the Pune, you can start their work over, but we don't go here because we have some of the certain knowledge about the Hinjewadi area. We have the R&D over there. So where we can assure, we are assured that area is going to develop. Government is also doing something for the ITs and all. After that, some of the thing like that, some of the big player, which have their big townships, 700 acre, 500 acre, so that 500 acres will become town, that the area is automatically will developed. So if the big player coming with the government, the two factor is coming as compared to other places, that area will grow like anything.
And that's an answer to you for the consumers out there. What Vivek is saying is that one, check out whether new townships are coming up in that area. Those townships become growth centers by themselves, and that impinges on the plot that you are buying. The second thing that you're saying is that there should be a job.
Connectivity and jobs.
Yeah.
So there must be connectivity from the highway. The land, if you are going to somewhere by, there must be a near about the connectivity from the highway, ring road, and big roads. Because right. Roads play important role in your investment.
Pankaj, would you like to add something to this?
Yes, the same thing Vivek sir has told. The next development which is going to come also plays a major factor. And there you can get a land at a reasonable rate. So the investments of NA plots at a budget of 5 to 10 lakhs can be done in the upcoming areas. After that areas which are going to be developed. Basically, the area which has been developed, as Vivek sir has rightly said, we can get an NA plot by 5 to 10 lakhs over here. So the people who are having a small budget or having a long period of investment, they can try on the future coming areas.
And those areas you feel that you should check for connectivity, you should check for job hubs, and you should check for large townships coming up.
At present in Pune, the connectivity has not become a major problem now. Most of the areas are well connected by roads, and the roads are of a good quality also.
Okay. There's Vijay Singh who says, are low budget plots more popular in Pune or premium lands? What gives you better appreciation? Should you buy a 2,000 square feet plot? Should you buy a 11,000 square feet plot? Which one gives you better appreciation? How do you assess that?
This depends on the purpose of the customer who is buying. If he's buying basically for investment only, as big the land, as good the investment, and it depends on the time of his waiting, how much period he is ready to wait. So that will be also be a driving factor for that.
Vivek, when you buy as an investor, you must also buy a plot that is easy to liquidate whenever you want to get out of that market, right?
Every developer have some of the project that project people don't sold. They have their security. Somehow I have some of the land at prime location of Hinjewadi. I don't sold the land. We have some of the bad times. If we required in night 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock money, I can sell and I can get my money back. So every investor, some also have some different type of bucket. They should not be the same, all the investment in same.
Right. So you are actually advising people to spread their investment, right?
Definitely. They should be, if they want to safe and secure investment, they should be. Either whatever the project is, very good or very bad, that is different. But yeah, every project have different prospect. So they should some of the different type of buckets.
And how do I assess the prospects of each of the land? Suppose I decide that I want to spend, say I have 30 lakhs, I buy for 10 lakhs in three different projects. But how do I assess what is the prospect of the land 5 years from now?
You can very easily, you can take the 5 years of track record of that area, what was the rate and what's going on. If I'm talking about the Hinjewadi, 5 years back, what land was the 3 lakh rupees gunta? Currently, that land raise is 45 lakh rupees gunta. The ratio of Hinjewadi in 5 years. Yeah. The Marunji area, which is extremely currently, there's no land about in that area. Hinjewadi, Marunji, somehow some of the Nere area, some of the Jambe area, which coming with the Tathawade. So that's of the area growing like anything. So once you feel like that, ki you are going to invest that area, which is upcoming area, which is not very far, is coming on the way, it's upcoming. So that in India, the development is basically the wide road. See, you just government or private people, you just made the road. In a few months, you will find so many shops in around the road. We believe development means roads and the lights. If you give road and lights, people are very brave in India. They make their market very easily.
Okay. I'm going to ask you gentlemen one question. We are all locked in. We are all talking from our own respective houses, right? Has this COVID lockdown impacted the sale of plots in Pune?
Should I go for it?
Yes, please.
At present, the situation will be some 2-3 months. This will be a tension. After the COVID is over, then the people will be preferring outside areas. Now they are facing the city area difficulties. At present, the paid areas and all are sealed. So they know the difficulties which they have to face for this type of pandemics when they are coming in the city areas. So they will prefer going and making some provision for the outside for their future. If anything, something comes again like this, so they will be making their provision. So I think so that will be a growth driver and not a hamper. It will help in the plotting sale of the plotting projects.
Are you seeing a lot of people coming in and making inquiries right now, even during the lockdown?
Yes. Today I sell 4 plots. Only two days.
And why is that? What has changed in this COVID psychology?
I believe something different from what people think. I believe currently the middle class, for the example, I have 65 people which is working in my company. I'm paying all of my employee. They are locked down in their home. They are not coming out. The expenses is finished, but income is getting what they are getting. So they are saving more as compared to the free time. So if we are thinking the lockdown impact two people only, one which is on daily basis, one which is earning in the million. Lockdown didn't affect the middle class people. Middle class making their money in the lockdown because they don't have the expenses. So it's lockdown for the people who is below the like a labor class, which is not our client, and effect to the people which are millionaire and billionaire, which is not our client. So both which is affected for them, that they're not client of the plots. I don't believe there is any discrepancy in the market which come fall down. Market will grow up like anything once it will be open. I have some of the statistics I'm showing you. when the lockdown we are working currently, we are working work from home. Our mm-hmm. employees working work from home. I have some of the example. When the lockdown was over, my employee was calling, and we was getting almost every one employee get 4 to 5 interested people in a day. They find. Currently, we are finding 8 to 9 people because people are at the home. They have time. They have time. They love to talk, and the sales start once you talk. So people are talking. So people are buying. Huh? They are saying it was everything is fine. Was once it will over, we'll come to see and we'll finalize. So what I believe the sales is increasing. If you think in my side, if you think sales is increasing, once it will be over, there will be huge sales. And they had started with sales earlier. The people from the inside and which due to some their COVID-19, they go to their hometown. They won't buy their land in Pune, near around in Pune. They want to stay now here.
Pankaj, are you seeing something similar?
Yes, 100%. The sales are increasing. The inquiries are increasing. The conversions will be 100% after this lockdown and everything is over. The conversion will be more.
Okay. So what happens when if I'm interested, if I'm somebody who's looking for a property, is it on the basis of what a salesperson is telling me on the telephone, or is it that I would actually like to see the property as well?
I'm just telling you something. Today I talked to one client personally. Some of my employees gave me the call. Sir, he is the client, he want to book today. I tell him, he's seen the plot. He said, no, he will come to see. Once he will come to see, how he will buy right now? He told me, I have taken CN over Google Map and everything. I'm okay with that. Once we'll come, we'll do all those things. So you have few plot over there. Buy a token, you just get 25,000 rupees. Once I will come, we'll decide the thing. I was surprised with the people's the mindset, ki people who don't see the land, they are going to buy. I asked them again, you are going to buy, but you don't see the land. But no issue, sir. I will come. I will see. I know about that thing. No issue. You don't need to worry for. He told me you don't need to worry for that. I thought, what's
okay? That is the level of interest in buying plots. This is probably the reason why we are talking about plots today, because we have noticed that there is an enhanced inquiry as well.
See, in a land, I'm telling you one thing very clear. If you are going to buy a land, that paper is clear. You buy anywhere in the world, anywhere in the Pune, anywhere in the Maharashtra, and after a period of time, you will get increment only. None of the region vehicle will decrease your money. If you are in flats, if you are in some another things, it may due to some reasons, it may down the line also. But in land, there is no issue.
You never lose money. That's your assurance.
If you are clear with the papers, that's the very important.
If the papers and the sanctions are on the table, there is 100% appreciation. It's same as an imitation jewelry and a gold jewelry. Gold jewelry is anywhere, anytime cashable. And the imitation jewelry, which is difficult, is in papers. It's difficult to cash them.
So when I buy a plot of land, how difficult is it for me to exit the land? For instance, I had bought 5 years ago. If I want to sell it, what is the process? Is it difficult for to sell plot from Pune as individual?
If you are going to find a client by your end, it's very difficult. Because you are doing your business. If you are going to find a client. But if you want to sell some of the developer which you have already taken, they will take your land. Everybody have the buyback option. I don't think so. None of the developer have that. Definitely. But if you think like the developer going to margin, they are margin with the 2 lakhs, 3 lakhs. I want the same margin. You can't get it. Because they have their so many efforts over there. They have their employee, they have their advertisements, so many things. So you can give their plots with the certain margin to their developer. But if you want to find some client, definitely you have to do post your land on the magic bricks. You will get the client as we do.
And does this get built into the builder buyer agreement, the buyback option?
I hope so. In Hinjabadi, most of the developer have. Most of them.
Pankaj, do you also have buyback options?
We don't give any type of offers for like buyback. But surely it's an exitable property. We can help the client if he's interested in exiting the land. We do help him, but we don't assure any buyback or like that.
Okay.
But it's surely an exitable.
Okay. And now there's a question from Shilpi who says, what kind of restrictions you should consider before buying plots in Pune? This is especially if you're buying near water bodies, near airports and all that. What kind of restrictions normally come up?
As far as sanction projects are concerned, they should not worry anything about this, because before giving the sanctions, looking in my case, my property is just close to an airport which is coming nearby. So we have taken the defense, the airport authority and everything prior to the sanctions. The PMRD has asked us to take these all permissions, and then only they are giving us the permission for the project. So for the sanction project, they did not worry anything of this sort. If they are interested in the location, interested in the plot, and they like the property, they should go forward for it.
Okay, here we are talking about gated communities. There's a there's Nitesh Sharma who said, can you avail a loan to buy plots from farmers? Should you buy farmland? Is it a safe bet? What would you say, Pankaj?
The minimum ticket size, as Vivek sir has initially told, 11,000 square foot is the bare minimum requirement. So that can be an official transaction. And if he's able to buy that big quantity, he can buy from farmers. The loans are not available for farmlands. So he has to make his own provision or some other alternative loan arrangements.
SBI now taking the initiative to give loan on farming land.
Okay.
SBI.
Even if I'm not a farmer, I'm allowed to buy agricultural land?
No, not at all in Maharashtra. You must be a farmer if you are going to buy farming land.
That is the basic requirement again.
Which means that if I'm an urbanite, I should not think of buying.
Everybody is farmer in India. You must be belong to some village. India is the country of village. So if you are living in Mumbai, but definitely you must have some village. Either you have, your in-laws have, anybody have, must be. So I didn't find any person who don't know about the village. If you are the Indian, you don't know the village, it can't be possible.
There's Jitesh Kumar who says, is land leasehold in Pune or freehold? What should you consider, a freehold or leasehold? Pune land is freehold?
Most of the land is freehold only.
There is no restriction in the government of such sort. It's a leasing or freehold. The property developer puts in the papers in that way. So you must check that if when you are buying the land, if it's a leasehold agreement which he's making with you or a sale deed. Once the sale deed is done, it can be most plotting projects are freehold plotting projects.
Okay. Now, Mihir Pandey says, my budget is 7 to 8 lakhs and I want to buy land in Pune in a peaceful area where you have greenery as well. I want to construct in 4 to 5 years. Where should I buy? When we were doing our study, we found there were several areas of Pune where it is peripheral. It is, on the extreme peripheries of the city, but it is extremely beautiful and there are lakes, there is greenery and so on. Do you think that's a safe bet? That's a good thing to do?
So, some of the company have their farmhouse project. I recommend to the people who are not from there, they are the workings. Because if they buy, after they have feel some of the problem, they feel like that land have the problem. Because land don't have the problem. Their buying attitude have the problem. If you are going to buy with some of the developer, you can say that you should do for me. But if you are going to buy with the farmer, they are not the professional. They will not give you something like that. So if you are going to buy a farming land or farmhouse project anywhere, also that you go with any developer so that he can help you on every prospect. So some of the developer have the project where they can meet their requirement, like greenery, lake, like some of the project in Pachane, Pushane, Kasa side dam have huge dam with so many projects, so they can buy over there.
Actually, I think
it's a 6 kilometer from the city, 6 kilometer only.
Right. And I think if I were to put it in a nutshell, what you're saying is that one, if you're buying from the farmers, it should be at least 11,000 square feet. Otherwise, you can't convert it into your own land. The second thing is that you should apply. You should check all the. Otherwise, it's not transferable. The second thing that you're saying. Sorry, please finish.
I told if they are buying less than 11,000, the transaction will not complete it as per the government rules currently.
Right. And the second thing that you said is if you're buying in the periphery, you must check the title of the land. You must be sure that, and today you can check it digitally, you can check it online, right? Wherever you're buying.
There is a website, it's named eSearch Maharashtra. eSearch Maharashtra. You go there and you check every land's record over there. The land record you can find. The people are going to sell their land. The land is with their name or not. How much area they have. How much they have sold. You can check everything over there. Even you can find all those indexed over there.
And how do you discover the price of the land? How do you figure out what value you're getting the house, the plot at? It's according to market standards?
See, developer decide like what they buy, what the expense coming, and what profit he are going to make. Once we club all those things, a price automatically come out.
This is again a question for you only, Vivek. What should you, there's Trivedi Singh who says, what should be your budget to buy in Hinjewadi area?
Like Hinjewadi area have a different type of budget. From 10 lakh to 30 lakhs, land is available. 10 lakh to 40 lakhs, land is available from Hinjewadi, 10 lakh to 40 lakhs.
10 lakhs to 40 lakhs. So there you are, Trivedi. 10 lakhs to 40 lakhs is what Vivek says is a good value. Sheikh Naima says, what happens to the plot market which are already developed and the government is not likely to propose any infrastructure project, which means that its drivers are already there. Then should one consider such localities for investment? Pankaj, you want to take this?
I can surely. Actually, as I have answered this before also, government is a factor. It may be 10-20%. After the sales are done, the area starts developing automatically. The rates are improving. The person who is having the land besides our plotted project, he also increases his plot land rates. So that doesn't make a big difference if the project doesn't happen over there or the development doesn't come over there. The other things are moving. The roads are being developed. The people have moved their urbanization activities, like some people build their houses and all over there. So that are sufficiently growth drivers for them.
Okay. And if the value has already risen to some extent, do you think it's still worthwhile buying a plot then?
It may be by some reasons the value has not increased immediately or within a period of some time. It's surely a good investment if the land title people are good. They can wait and the rotation comes. Now, where the Viman Nagar area is there, initially 100 rupees square feet the land was there. Now, 5,000 rupees square feet, we can't get a plot over there. So, the time depends how long it will take, but it will give a good appreciation for sure.
There is Thomas Michael who says he purchased 2,000 square feet, Chikrapur near Chakan. I want to develop. Is it going to develop? Is it a, should he hold on to the plot? Should he develop himself?
Chikrapur is a good destination. The ring road is passing nearby from there. The rates will increase in future. If he's having the waiting capacity, he can wait. He'll get the good returns from there.
How long should he wait? What is your estimate?
Now, giving the timeline is a difficult task, but looking at the development, 2 to 3 years will be a good time for him. He'll get a good return from there.
Sure. Shagil Khan is asking, if you're buying land in Pune, how many floors can you construct and how is that restricted in certain locations?
Rightly said initially also that depending on the sanctions of the project, government gives you the FSI calculations. The roads which have been left, the amenity space, open space, and everything. The area is minus from the developer side and it's increased on the plot area. That's called the pro rata FSI. Depending on that FSI, you have the construction limits set. So it can be for a basic sanctioned plotting project. Parking plus 3-4 floors is the standard which consumes the FSI. And then if you have an extra big plot, you can take on the additional premium FSIs and all, and you can increase more.
And can you sell them floor by floor in Pune?
As I told, basically parking plus 3 is the standard consumption now. Parking plus 3 floors. And if you are having a big plot above 4,000, 5,000 square foot, you can buy additional TDR and premium FSI also.
No, can you sell individual floors, builder floors?
After that, you can, if your building is a sanctioned building, you can sell individual units.
There is Sagar who says he wants to buy a plot for investment in Pune. Can you suggest me a few locations? I think they've already suggested. Yeah. And there's another guy, Nitesh Rao, who lives in Delhi and wants to buy in Pune for investment. If I invest in that today, what should be the appreciation in the next 5 years? Is there a rule of thumb? If I buy for 10 lakh in a certain number of years, does it double, treble, depending on what? Is there a rule of thumb?
There can't be a rule for that, but looking into the past history, as I given you in your early area, as sir has given you the example of India, I given you the example of Imannagar area, it's multiplying. Just it's, we are safer side that it will be two or three folds, but it's multiplying. 100 rupees has become 5,000 rupees within a period of 10 to 15 years. So that factor you can understand. That's not a timeline, but surely it's an appreciation.
What happens to the Vimannagar, Kharadi, Magarpatta area now that the airport is going to move into another part of the city? What will happen to its values? Will there be a drop in value or something?
That will not make a big difference as the urbanization has already been done over there. The land is not available for any future big construction of this future project. The land parcels are very less. So that will not make a big impact on the land of Kharadi or Vimannagar. The urbanization is already done.
Okay. And Nitesh Rao also says that how do you make sure that the land is safe from encroachment?
For that only we develop projects from a qualified developer who has gated communities. So there you don't have to worry. If you don't come to your plot also for 5-10 years, there is nothing going to be disturbed. All the boundaries, when the layout is sanctioned, all the points are, and there you don't have to worry for your property. If you come along after 5-10 years also, you'll find everything is over there.
And our last question for the day, what facilities should you look for when you buy plot projects? We did briefly touch upon this, but because a consumer is asking, would you like to say what are the must-have facilities that you should look for and what are the good to have?
Basic must-have facilities, as I think the external compound wall for the project, the internal plot compounds, the roads which should be developed, the MSEB connections, the electricity board connections, for that the transformers and all lines should be taken care by the developer. The water lines, these are the basic and the electricity for the common roads and all. These are the basic requirements which must be there, which the plot owner cannot do on his own as an individual. So these basic requirements must be there, then he can easily construct his home for future work.
You want to add to that, Vidit?
No, he's actually right.
Okay. And that's where we are going to, what will be the one last question, Vardhaman says, what will be the scenario for affordable housing in Pune after COVID-19? A quick last question for you, Vivek. What do you think will be
Affordable housing is not going to affect for anything. The project which have the big budget project, they will affect. But affordable housing will be run like anything, because affordable housing going to buy people who need the home. People not going to buy with the who have the second home. So who needy people have their need always. So after COVID-19, the sale will be remain like affordable housing. Some big project may be affected.
Pankaj, you want to add to that? What is the impact?
Rightly said by Vivek, sir. Actually, many people are living in substandard housing at present. They have faced the problems in this 40 days lockdown. So they'll surely be interested in upgrading their living standard. So I think so. Affordable housing will have a boost after this COVID, I think.
Thank you so much, gentlemen, for joining us. Thank you for all those queries, all the people who are logged in. Clearly, there is a huge demand, huge interest in buying plots in Pune. And from the range of questions, you can make out that these are end users who actually want answers from people like you who are experts in the plot market. Thank you so much for joining. I'm Jayashree Kurup, and thank you for joining the Property Show.
Thank you so much.